By the end of February 2025, Russia's civil aviation sector had made noticeable progress in its efforts to reduce dependency on foreign aircraft and components. In this video, I'll give you a detailed update on the development of four major aircraft projects: the Superjet 100, the MS-21, the Tupolev Tu-214, and the Ilyushin Il-114. And in the final section, we'll also take a close look at the LMS-901 Baikal, an aircraft project that's facing some serious challenges. So let's get into the latest developments. Superjet 100. The Superjet 100, originally known as the Sukhoi Superjet 100, is a Russian short-haul regional aircraft developed for domestic routes. As part of the import substitution program, this aircraft is undergoing major changes. In February 2025, the Yakovlev company received PD-8 engines from the United Engine Corporation. These new Russian-made engines are designed to replace the SAM-146 engines, which were developed jointly with the French. Ground tests with the PD-8 have already been conducted, but now with the newly delivered engines, flight tests can begin. The test aircraft is a 2018-built Superjet with tail number 9712. Another prototype, number 90072, which began testing in 2023, is currently being used to test additional components. A third prototype is also expected to join the test program soon. Russia's Minister of Industry and Trade, Anton Alekhanov, stated, "We hope that within a month or a month and a half, we will begin flight tests using the Superjet fitted with the new PD-8 engine, and this will mark the start of the certification journey for the engine as part of the aircraft." In February, a major milestone was achieved when tail number 9704, the first production Superjet with Russian systems, was powered up for the first time. At the Komsomolskon Amur production plant, 11 Superjet 100 airframes have been assembled. These aircraft will be equipped with the PD-8 engines and Russian-made onboard systems once the certification process is complete. Yakovlev is also expanding production capacity. A 10,000 square meter logistics center is being built in Komsomolsk on Amur, which will include an engine assembly line for the Superjet 100. Additionally, Russia's first facility for assembling doors and hatches for civil aircraft has opened there. This facility will serve the MC-21, Superjet 100, Ilyushin 114, and Tupolev 214 programs. On February 26, the Ministry of Industry and Trade announced a public tender for research and development, focused on certifying the fully domestically built version of the Superjet. The certification work is expected to be completed by the end of 2027. The maximum cost of the project is estimated at 27.6 billion rubles, and the results of the tender will be announced on March 18th. Tupolev Tu-214. The Tupolev Tu-214 is a medium-range airliner developed by the Tupolev Design Bureau. It can carry up to 210 passengers over 6,500 kilometers and is currently being produced at the Kazan Aircraft Production Association, named after Gorbunov. Minister Anton Alekhanov confirmed that the first Tupolev Tu-214s will be delivered to customers in 2025 under the government's aviation development program. In November 2024, the first Tupolev Tu-214 built entirely with Russian components completed its maiden flight. The flight lasted 1 hour and 10 minutes and marked a major step in the import substitution effort. In June 2024, the state corporation Rostec announced that the Kazan aircraft plant had completed retooling its production lines for Tupolev Tu-214 manufacturing. Although the original goal was to produce 4 aircraft in 2025, that number has been revised to 2. Replacement of foreign components is ongoing. Russian engineers are working on new avionics, radar systems, lighting, hydraulics, electrical equipment, and flight control systems. A new integrated aircraft management system is also in development for a two-pilot cockpit. In total, 15 major systems and 30 secondary systems are being replaced with Russian-made alternatives. The Kazan plant is continuing its modernization efforts, launching several new facilities in 2024 to support increased production in the future. MS-21. The MS-21 is Russia's new generation medium-range airliner, originally designed with help from international suppliers. But after Western sanctions in 2022, more than 80 foreign systems needed to be replaced. As a result, the aircraft's weight has increased by 5.75 tons, but development continues. In early February 2025, the fully Russian-built MS-21 prototype, serial number MS-0013, was powered up at the Irkutsk aviation plant. On February 21st, the United Engine Corporation delivered a new batch of PD-14 engines for several assembled aircraft. The PD-14 engine is a significant achievement. UEC developed 16 critical technologies for it, including new materials, coatings, and structures. It features the world's lightest hollow titanium fan blades. Only 5 countries in the world, Russia, the US, the UK, France, and China, have the capability to produce such engines from start to finish. Minister Alikhanov confirmed on February 7th that certification flights with the PD-14-powered MS-21 are expected to begin soon. On January 24th, the Ministry of Industry and Trade announced that a new version of the aircraft, the shorter MS-21-210, will be developed using internal funding from the United Aircraft Corporation. A budget of 1.94 billion rubles was approved for this development through 2025, and no additional federal funding is expected. In January 2025, 2 test flights were conducted using aircraft number 73054 to evaluate the de-icing systems. However, Rostec CEO Sergei Chemezov confirmed that full-scale deliveries of the MS-21 have been delayed to 2026 due to the ongoing import substitution and certification work. Ilyushin 114. The Ilyushin 114 is a Russian turboprop regional aircraft originally designed in the 1980s by the Ilyushin Design Bureau. It can carry up to 64 passengers on routes up to 2,000 kilometers and is especially well suited for regional airports with limited infrastructure. In September 2024, the Russian government allocated over 12.5 billion rubles for continued development of the Ilyushin 114-300 from 2025 to 2027. The total investment for the program is expected to reach 99.4 billion rubles, including 706 million in 2026 and nearly 2.5 billion in 2027. In January 2025, the United Aircraft Corporation received an additional 499 million rubles for refinement work. On March 31st, 2024, UAC announced that flight testing of the Ilyushin 114-300 had resumed. The second prototype successfully completed its first flight, moving the project closer to certification. The aircraft is expected to be certified by the end of 2025, with initial deliveries beginning in 2026. Full-scale production aimed at 12 aircraft per year is planned for 2027 to 2028. In August 2024, prototype 54115 was sent to Ulyanovsk to be painted in UAC corporate colors. By September, the aircraft had completed over 30 test flights, some lasting more than 7 hours. After painting, another 30 flights followed. Between January 20th and 30th, 2025, the aircraft completed 8 certification flights. Red Wings Airlines is expected to receive the first 3 Ilyushin 114 in 2026, followed by 5 more in 2027. In September 2024, the State Transport Leasing Company signed a preliminary agreement to buy 65 Ilyushin 114 aircraft between 2027 and 2032. LMS-901 Baikal. Finally, let's look at the LMS-901 Baikal, a light aircraft developed to replace the aging Antonov An-2. Although there were rumors that the project might be cancelled, both the Ministry of Industry and Trade and Vladimir Barsuk, director of the Chaplygin Siberian Aeronautical Research Institute, confirmed it will continue. However, there are major challenges. Serious design flaws have been discovered, including poor low-speed stability, high control forces on the yoke, and the need to redesign the tail section, move the tailwheel, and upgrade the landing gear. Experts estimate it may take 3 to 5 years to fix these problems. In May 2024, the Ural Civil Aviation Plant announced plans to deliver 5 Baikals in 2025, but that timeline has now shifted to 2026. Another issue is cost. In August, the aircraft's price jumped to 455 million rubles, far above the original price cap of 120 million rubles set in 2019. By September, the price had been reduced to 260 million rubles. Total investment in the Baikal project is now estimated at 1.8 billion rubles, but to complete the necessary improvements, an additional 10 billion rubles will be required, 3 times more than originally planned in 2022. On February 27th, Minister Alykhanov stated that production of the TVD-10 turboprop engine will resume. These engines could be used to re-engine existing AN-2 aircraft and might serve as a backup if the Baikal project experiences further delays. So where does Russian civil aviation stand in 2025? The country is clearly making an aggressive push toward independence from foreign components and systems. The Superjet, MS-21, Tupolev Tu-214, and Ilyushin Il-114 projects are all advancing, though with varying timelines and levels of complexity. Meanwhile, the Baikal remains in a difficult position technically and financially. Will these aircraft reshape Russia's aviation future, or will the delays and design flaws hold them back? Let me know what you think in the comments, and don't forget to subscribe for more in-depth aviation content from EMAviation. Thank you for watching till the end. Goodbye.